Good evening, everyone, and a Merry Christmas to everyone here. And to you at home, truly Merry Christmas. I just want to lead off in prayer. Loving Father, we celebrate and thank you, truly thank you, for your love revealed in Jesus. In this moment, we pause and reflect and remember the significance of God becoming flesh and coming to be with his creation, us. By the leading of your Holy Spirit, give us new appreciation and imagination for all this season holds. May your hope, love, joy, and peace fill us as we follow you, Jesus. We pray this in your name. Amen. I want to start off with the lighting of the Advent candles, and I have a few things to read. So the first candle we will light is that of the hope candle. Tonight, we come to remember and proclaim the light of hope. Hope in the promises of God. Hope in the power of the Holy Spirit. Hope in the person of Jesus Christ. Hope for each and every one of us. And hope for all of us. The second candle we will light is that of the love candle. We come to proclaim the light of love. Love conceived by the Creator. Love enlivened by the Holy Spirit. Love fulfilled in the life and death and resurrection of Jesus. Love within us and among us. The third candle we will light is that of the joy candle. We come to proclaim the light of joy. Joy in our relationship with our Creator. Joy in the fulfillment of the Spirit. Joy in our salvation through Jesus. Joy deep within us in times of happiness and in sorrow. The fourth candle we will light is that of peace. We come to remember and proclaim the light of peace. Peace as we trust God's power. Peace as we know the Spirit's presence. Peace as we follow Jesus' path. Peace within our hearts and peace throughout the world. And what is perhaps the most important of the candles, which is the very reason we are here, is referred to as a Christ candle. Because we come to receive the light of Christ. As we celebrate his miraculous birth, we receive the light that illuminates the holy path of hope, love, joy, and peace. And so I say to you, to every one of us, for a child has been born of us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace For the throne of David and his kingdom, he will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from the time onwards and forevermore. Amen.
Happy birthday, Jesus. Thank you for every birthday for Jesus. It's Merry Christmas for every day.
Thank you.
And our first performer there was Jairus, which, according to the Bible, Jesus refers to them as the greatest of these. So bless him for praising you, Lord. So I invite you all to come, all ye faithful. In the sixth month of Elizabeth's pregnancy, God sent the angel Gabriel to Nazareth, a town in Galilee, to a virgin pledged to be married to a man named Joseph, a descendant of David. The virgin's name was Mary. The angel went to her and said, "Greetings, you are highly favored. The Lord is with you." Mary was greatly troubled at his words and wondered what kind of greeting this might be. But the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God. You will conceive and give birth to a son, and you are to call him Jesus. He will be great and will be called the Son of the Most High. The Lord God, the Lord God will give him the throne of his father David, and he will reign over Jacob's descendants forever, His kingdom will never end. How will this be? Mary asked the angel, since I am a virgin. The angel answered, the Holy Spirit will come on you, and the power of the Most High will overshadow you, so the Holy One will be born, will be called the Son of God. Even Elizabeth, your relative, is going to have a child in her old age, and she who was said to be unable to conceive is in her sixth month. For no word from God will ever fail. I am the Lord's servant, Mary answered. May your word be fulfilled. Then the angel left her.
Thank you.
through 45. At that time, Mary got ready and hurried to a town in the hill, country of Judea, where she entered Zechariah's home and greeted Elizabeth. When Elizabeth heard Mary's greeting, the baby leaped in her womb, and Elizabeth was filled with the Holy Spirit. In a loud voice, she exclaimed, "Blessed are you among women, and blessed is the child you will bear. But why am I so favored that the mother of my Lord should come to me? As soon as the sound of your greeting reached my ears, the baby in my womb leaped for joy. Blessed is she who has believed that the Lord would fulfill his promises to her."
Thank you.
Luke 2, 1 through 7. In those days, Caesar Augustus issued a decree that a census should be taken of the entire Roman world. This was the first census that took place while Quirinius was governor of Syria. And everyone went to their own town to register. So Joseph also went up to the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to Bethlehem, the town of David, because he belonged to the house and line of David. He went there to register with Mary, who was pledged to be married to him and was expecting a child. While they were there, the time came for the baby to be born, and she gave birth to her firstborn, a son. She wrapped him in cloths and placed him in a manger because there was no guest room available for them.
Luke 2, 8 through 12.
And there were shepherds living out in the fields nearby, keeping watch over their flocks at night. An angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring to you good news, and that will cause great joy for all the people. Today, in the town of David, a Savior has been born to you. He is the Messiah, the Lord." Hallelujah. "This will be a sign to you. You will find a baby wrapped in cloth and lying in a manger." Suddenly, a great company of the heavenly host appeared with the angel, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace to those of whom his favor rests." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, and the shepherds said to one another, "Let's go to Bethlehem and see this thing that has happened, which the Lord has told us about." So they hurried off and found Mary and Joseph and the baby who was lying in the manger. When they had seen him, they spread the word concerning what had been told them about this child. And all who heard it were amazed at what the shepherds said to them. But Mary treasured up all these things and pondered them in their heart. The shepherds returned, glorifying and praising God for all the things they had heard and seen, which were just as they had been told. Amen.
Me all my days.
Our last song is probably one of the important ones, if anything, as we remember this year what has gone on. And it is a reminder for all of us, just as we lit these candles, just to walk in the light. Walk in the light of Jesus. God bless you all, and really, truly, a Merry Christmas.